Hello, friends. How's all my elementary students doing? K through six. I hope all is well. And I think by now, if you're coming back to school, you should be in school this week. So welcome back to school. We are very happy to have you back into the buildings. You bring such life and joy into the classrooms. So I wanted to take a minute and just kind of come into our time together. So I want to do a make yourself comfortable activity, kind of like a mindfulness. I want you to check in with your body. Take a deep breath in and out. In and out. So ask yourself, as you are checking in with your body, does your body need anything right now? Does it need anything to make you feel more comfortable? So do you need to stretch, or do you need to take a walk or relax, or just take some deep breaths in? And if you do, I want you to just take a minute or 30 seconds to a minute and just do that for yourself. Take that time to do what your body needs to feel comfortable, okay? And I really hope that made you feel like more comfortable. Sit up in your chair and just put your shoulders back a little bit and just relax. So let's get into what we're gonna be talking about today. So we have been talking about our fifth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, SEL competency, which is responsible decision-making. And so this is actually the last competency in our wheel of SEL competencies. But we're going to be talking about the indicators today is executive functioning and critical thinking. So what is this big word that I'm saying, executive functioning? Basically, it's the use of our, you know, upstairs brain, our prefrontal cortex. That's what it's about. So it's the management part of the brain. It's the part of our brain that manages all of the things as goals and planning and ways to get things done. So it's the organizational part of the brain. It's where we kind of think about what we're going to do next and how we're going to do it. It's all those steps that we take. And three main parts to our executive functioning. And one is our working memory. So what do we remember? How do we remember to do something? So when we learn a math problem, our teacher taught us, how do we remember to do those steps? That's your working memory. Second part is your cognitive flexibility. So what's my flexible thinking? So if my teacher we're in the middle of doing that math assignment, and then she says, okay, class, we need to hurry up and clean up because we got to move on to something else. How quickly does your mind shift and you're able to clean up and then get out whatever it is that she wants you to get out for your next assignment or next project that you're going to be working on? So that's your cognitive flexibility. And then there's the inhibitory control. And that is basically your self-control. How do you control your impulses, the impulse control? So I'm gonna share my screen and hopefully this works because things have been a little funny lately. And I am going to show a video that hopefully helps explain this a little more of our executive function.
The Adventures of You, Part 2. A brain full of lasers. Inside your brain are three amazing powers: impulse inhibition, working memory, and mental flexibility. Scientists call these executive functions. Each one builds on the next, like levels. Level zero, sleepwalking. If you have no executive function at all, you have no control over your choices. You do whatever comes into your head. You lose your temper easily or treat people badly. You don't pay attention or plan ahead, so you make the same mistakes over and over again. If something doesn't go well, you just give up. Because you get distracted easily, you can't practice enough to get good at anything. So you never grow. You never get better. Level 1. Impulse inhibition. Impulse inhibition stops you doing whatever it is that pops into your head. It helps you stop and think. You might think whether what you're about to do is smart or safe, kind or fair, useful or productive. When you stop and think, you begin to take control over your life. Level 2. Working memory. Impulse inhibition helps free up something in your brain called working memory. Working memory is awesome. It's what lets you keep in mind more than one thing at a time. You can keep in mind your goals and priorities, or other people's thoughts and feelings, or all the different things happening around you. You can handle more complex tasks because you're able to think about more steps. And with strong working memory, you can plan and manage your way through even the toughest of challenges. However, what if things don't go according to plan? Well, that's when you need Level 3. Mental flexibility. Finally, at level 3, you have the power of mental flexibility. This means you can not only keep different things in mind, but you can combine them to create new plans and ideas. You can find new ways to manage yourself, new ways to learn, new ways to get along with others. You can work with people to solve big challenges. You can experiment, innovate, create, go beyond your limits, beyond your normal, into something new. At level 3, you are a true adventurer, equipped to make your way in the world. But where are you now? Level 1? Level 2? Level 3? Level 0? It's level 0, isn't it? Is that what you wanted?
Hopefully.
Where did you want to be? There's a way to get there, you know. In the next video, you can watch it now. Or you can watch those crazy cat videos. They're awesome.
So, that kind of showed you how, like, when you're, like, sleepwalking or not knowing what you're doing, that's that, that cognitive inability, that where you're not able to think about what it is that you're doing, you're just doing it, right? So there are ways and things that you can do to kind of practice, you know, your critical thinking or your executive functioning, how to make it better, or worse better, because we all have times in the day or times when our executive functioning skills are not working very well. We're not organizing or planning right, or staying focused or on task with our work, understanding other people's views, regulating our emotions, or self-monitoring and managing ourselves, right? So one way to do this is to do like a free play freeze dance or red light, green light. Those are two easy ways, because what you're doing in this is you're having your body do one thing, and then when you hear the music stop, or somebody say red light, you stop. You're making your body physically stop. And so that's part of an executive functioning skill. So I'm going to play a video, and I want you guys to all kind of get up. And this is a way to kind of move your bodies again and have a little fun, but also work on your executive functioning skills. That is, if I can get out of this video, right? This video is not wanting to get out. So here we go. And here we go.
Music for a child's heart, body, and mind.
I'm not going to play the whole video, probably about maybe two. Maybe three
Move
minutes.
And Freeze from the award-winning CD, Brain Boogie Boosters, by The Learning Station.
See how easy it is to control your body.
Put your right hand on your left knee, your left hand on your right. Your knees move in and out, your hands stay tight. Now keep on with your moving, but switch hands on your knees. Keep on moving in and out till we say freeze. Come on,
move.
And freeze. Come on,
move.
And freeze.
Control your body.
Come on,
move.
And freeze. Come on,
move.
And freeze. Put one hand across your shoulder, one hand across your back. Now jump in place. Do you like it like that?
Yeah.
Now switch hands across your shoulders and switch hands across your back. Now just be nimble, just be quick, just like Jack. Come on,
jump
and freeze.
Control your body.
Come on,
jump
and freeze. Come on,
jump
and freeze. Come on,
jump
and freeze. Everybody shake your body from your head down to your feet. And don't stop shaking until we stop the beat. Shake it to the east and shake it to the west.
Shake it, shake it, shake it.
With my friends who are the best. Come on,
shake
and freeze. Come on,
shake
and freeze. Come on,
shake
and freeze. Come on,
shake
and freeze.
Thank you guys so much for playing along with the stop and freeze. But what is that? What's that doing? It's telling our brain. Our brain is doing one thing. It's working and we're moving. And then it hears the word stop. And then we have to then control and stop our body. So that is an executive functioning skill that helps to build our executive functioning muscle, if that's what you want to call it. So again, you can do that, or you can ask your teacher to play red light, green light. Any of those things will help to get your working memory up and your cognitive flexibility, along with your self-control and just your thinking and what we're doing. So I just want to thank you for our time together today. And if nobody has told you that I love you, I do, and I always will. I will see you again next week.